Hello students, today's topic is communication interface. In the last video, we have seen some of the I/O subsystem devices like LED, 7 segment display, stepper motor, keyboard and all. I/O subsystems are the device through which the user can interact with embedded system devices. These are the interfacing devices which connects outside world and the embedded system. Now the question is, which is connecting user and the I/O subsystem? The answer is communication interface devices. Communication interface devices are the connecting user and the I/O subsystems. So today we are going to see some of the communication interface devices only. There are two types of communication interfaces. First one is board or device level communication interface, that is also called onboard communication interface. Another one is product level communication interface, that is also called external communication interface. The first one, onboard communication interface. So we know embedded system is the embedded devices or the combination of different type of components which are arranged on a PCB, printed circuit board. So the communication device which connects all these different components with the embedded device is called onboard communication interface. So inside the board, which is used to connect all the devices, that is called onboard communication interface. Next, external communication interface. External communication interface are responsible for the communication between embedded system with the outside world. This external communication interface can be either wired media or wireless media, and it can be serial or parallel. Few of the examples of onboard communication is I2C bus, SPI bus, UART, one wire interface and parallel interface, and the external communication both wired and wireless, RS-232, USB, then wireless, Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, ZigBee and all. Now the first onboard communication interface which we are going to see is I2C bus, inter-integrated circuit bus. It is a synchronous bi-directional half duplex two-wire serial interface bus. Synchronous bi-directional half duplex two-wire serial interface bus. The term synchronous referred the transmitter and the receiver are synchronized by the clock. Next term, bidirectional. It refers both the transmission and can be in both the direction, means from data can be transmitter from transmitter as well as received, as well as transmission and reception. Next, the term half duplex means the transmission can be in one direction at a time, either transmit or receive. Next, this I2C bus is having two signal lines. One is serial clock line, another one is serial data line. This serial clock line is responsible for generating different synchronization clock pulses, and the serial data line is responsible for transmitting a serial data to the different devices. And the I2C, this I2C bus is a shared system, means here we can connect more number of I2C devices with the bus. And these connected devices can either act as master or slave. Here the master is responsible for controlling the communication by initiating or terminating the data transfer, sending data, and it also responsible for generating synchronization of clock pulses. And the slave will wait for the command from the master. Once the command is received, it will respond according to that. Both the bus lines, here we can see in the diagram, here we are seeing one master and two slaves. Both are connected with two bus lines, SCL and SDA. For the proper operation of this bus, both the bus lines, means SCL and SDA, should be connected with power supply. That power supply can be 5 volt for the TTL family devices and 3.3 volt for the CMOS family devices. So, and these bus lines are connected with the power supply using 2.2K pull-up resistors. These pull-up resistors will keep these two lines high. Now, the sequence of operation for the communication through I2C. So the first step, first master pulls the SCI line high and it makes the SDA line low. Then the master will be sending address of the slave to which it wants to make the communication. After sending the address, it also sends the read-write command bit. The bit value is 1 for read operation, bit value is 0 for write operation. After sending these two signals, after sending address and read-write command bit, it will wait for the acknowledgement from the slave. At the same time, all the slave devices which are connected in the bus will receive the address, and it will compare this address with the address which is assigned to it. And the particular slave whose address is matched with that address will respond to the master by sending acknowledgement bit. Acknowledgement bit is bit 1. After receiving the acknowledgement, master starts the communication. Master starts sending the data. It will send the data to the slave if the requested operation is right, or it will receive the data from the slave if the requested operation is read. Because write means sending data, read means receiving the data. So these are about I2C bus. Next we are going to see serial peripheral interface. Serial peripheral interface bus, it is also a synchronous bidirectional full duplex four-way serial interface bus. Synchronous bidirectional full duplex. Full duplex means it can transmit as well as receive at the same time. And it was introduced by Motorola. And it supports single master and multi-slave system. Single master and multi-slave system. But in the case of I2C, it can support multi-master system on the same bus. SPI requires four signal buses. The four signal buses are MOSI, master out, serial in, and MISO, master in, serial out, and SCL, serial clock, and chip slave select. Slave select. There are four. MOSI is used to carry the data. From the name itself, we can tell MOSI, master is sending the data, slave is receiving the data. So this is used to carry the data from master to slave. Next one, MISO. So this is used to carry the signal from slave to master. SCL, it is used to carry the clock signal. Then slave select, it is used to select the slave. Actually, it is an active low pin. It means we have to make it low to enable, to activate the device. Here, master is responsible for generating the clock pulse for the communication. And master will select the slave. Master will select the slave to which it wants to mix the communication by asserting the signal, slave select signal low. Then, the serial communication through the SPI is fully configurable. Fully configurable means it is having some set of registers to hold the configurations. There are two set of registers, serial peripheral control register and status register. This serial peripheral control registers hold some configuration parameters like master slave selection, baud rate selection for the communication, clock signal selection for the communication. And the status register, it is used to hold the status of the transmission and the reception. And here it works based on the shift register. All the master and slave devices will be having the shift register. So first we will consider this case, the transmission from master to slave. Transmission from master to slave. So during this transmission, which line will be activated? MOSI, because here master is going to out the data, slave is going to receive the data. So during that time, data from the master shift register will be shifted out to the MOSI. From this data, slave's shift register will receive the data. So whenever one bit is additionally added, one bit will be shifted out. That shifted out bit will be received by the master's shift register. So these two forms the circular form. To make the communication bidirectional, means bit by bit it will be transmitted, same time bit by bit it will be received. So it makes the bidirectional communication. Here the disadvantage of SPI buses, it will not support for the acknowledgement mechanism.